Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is BestInSlot with the brand new update. Just came out a couple days ago for Empires of the Undergrowth. This is the Leafcutter update. Not only does it add two brand new levels and a brand new Formicarium challenge, but it adds a brand new type of ant to the game, the Leafcutter ant. Now, just for those of you who may not have seen this game before, it's like Ant Sim a little bit. Sim Ant back in the day, great game. It's like a colony builder, fighting, harvesting sort of thing. And to explain what's going on here, this is the Formicarium. This is like our base. This is our ant farm, essentially. You can see if we go on to the overground map, it's all nicely decorated. There's some glass over here. It's just a... this is our home base. And the idea is we need to use resources gathered in missions to upgrade our home base. So if we go over to the level screen over here, in preparation for this video, I did 1.1, 1.2, 2.1 and 2.2. I completed all four of those so we could unlock these next two. And these two here are the Leafcutter ones. So you go from your Formicarium, you complete one of these levels, that gives you resources, that you come back, you upgrade your Formicarium, and then that lets you do the Formicarium challenges, which tend to throw just like an obscene amount of enemies at you, basically. And the idea is you have to complete those in order to unlock more levels down the line, although these are the last challenges in the entire game. So we're going to try the Leafcutter update. Now, before we carry on, I just want to say, this will be my third time trying to record this video. The Leafcutters handle and play in an entirely different way than every other sort of... every other ant in the game so far. Their feeding mechanisms and stuff are completely different. And I have not quite got my head around it. I've tried, I really have. I've tried, and I've still not quite managed it. I'm hopeful this is going to be it this time instead. We're going to go for... so basically, we're going to play a medium difficulty. I'm so tempted to put it on easy. I'm so tired of failing. Oh, the Leafcutters have kicked my ass, though. Anyways, and we also have unit options. So we're getting these new units called Majors. These are the big tanks of the Leafcutter army, and they get an ability at level 3, which is either a taunt or a stun. And I keep going for stun, and it keeps failing, so we're going to go for the taunt. Let's give it a go. The Harvest, level 3.1, on medium. I have watched somebody else on YouTube who played this on the extreme difficulty, or very hard, or whatever it's called, and I watched what they did. So I'm going to try to integrate some of that into the video, and also explain why the Leafcutters are different, and they very much are. So the first thing we're going to do is this. This young queen has successfully raised her first daughters beneath the leaf litter of the rainforest floor. The nutritious fungus she fed them as larvae is now dwindling. If they don't find food quickly, they will all starve. She's an absolute unit, isn't she? She's absolutely humongous. Alright, we need some juicy grubs nearby. Are a staple meal for many underground opportunists. But for now at least, they will go ignored. This budding Atacephalotus Leafcutter colony has only one viable source of food, and it must be collected above ground. Okay, so I'm just going to pause to explain what's going on and how Leafcutters work. So with the other ants, what you do is you go above ground and you pick up seeds, you pick up dead things, and you bring it back. You bring it back, bring it back now. You bring your food back to your base and you eat it. That's it. The Leafcutters operate in a completely different way. So you have to go and you can only harvest leaves. That's why they're called Leafcutters. So you go and harvest leaves. So you bring those leaves back to these things here. These are leaf storage. I'm going to put these right at the entrance. That's the first mistake I probably made last time. Okay, so if we knock that one out as well, yep. So he's going to make a little leaf storage, and we're going to put down that there. Okay, so basically you bring back the leaves, and now every time you make a breeding spot as a Leafcutter, you get a little ant, like you can see right here. These little dudes, these are called minims. And what the minims will do is they'll go to the leaf storage spot, they'll cut up the leaves, they'll drag it back to a breeding spot, they'll turn it into fungus, and then that fungus is used as food. And when that fungus is used as food, then it becomes waste, and the waste has to be decomposed in these spots over here, these sort of storage spots that I've made up there. With me so far. So it's a completely different system. What we're going to do is we're going to head up to the top.
The small scouting party of minor workers could lead any number of deadly jungle creatures back to their undefended queen. They will need time and luck on their side. The workers have located a patch of young seedlings, just what they were looking for. The leaves are soft enough to be sliced up with ease and carried back to the nest.
Doesn't it look really cool though? Look at them go. You see, they, so I didn't know you could do this. If you press control,
are not eaten directly. Oops, Daisy. Instead, they are used by the very smallest minim workers to cultivate a nutritious fungus.
Have no food! We need more food to make more leaf tiles. At the moment, we have no leaves. This is a mistake. Boop, there we go. So, wait, did I just build the right thing? Yeah, I'm fine. I'm going to build some leaf storage tiles right here. And that way, when our big ants, these are actually called the miners, these little ones that we're building right now. When they bring the leaves back, they should be able to just dump them down at the entrance and then go right back to harvesting. So that's the first thing I've changed since the 10 trillion other times I've tried to do this. you'll notice at the bottom, basically we've got these, this is called pheromone markers. This is basically how you group your ants together. Now, these are both groups of miners, but the miners are responsible for, they put down new spots and they dig out tunnels and stuff like that. So I've got 7 of them harvesting, but 4 of them back in order to make new miners and to harvest tunnels and do all this kind of stuff as well. I will try to explain what's going on as much as I know ever what's going on. But yeah, you hit control and it brings up this menu. I did not know this existed. This is something we're going to have to abuse a lot more going forward.
The nest have not gone unnoticed. They are being watched.
Bomb, bomb, bomb. By what? Oh, it's a jumping spider. Oh, it's a jumping spider. Okay, that's fine. Just gonna let my boys keep doing their job. We're gonna really max out on these miners, first of all. That is our first priority. Miners everywhere. Sounds a little bit weird, but what are you gonna do? Come on, there we go. And we're gonna need a little bit more of this stuff as well. So this is the rotting fungus, essentially. And you want to keep this further away, because if any of your normal ants walk through it, the minims, these little dudes, they can walk through it, but if the bigger ants walk through it, they'll become sick and get slowed down and they get like a weird little poisoning. So you need to keep that away from everything, basically. That is what we're trying to do. You can see how these are now both the same size. We've got a group of 7 and a group of 7. We're just going to send them all out to the top temporarily, so the whole army should come out here and get harvesting. This is 446. This plant here is humongous, has tons of stuff on it, so should be able to get loads and loads of leaf from it. And they look great, though, don't they? I love ants. Ants are fascinating. And just carrying these massive wedges of leaf around, and for them it is a thick wedge of leaf. It's very cool. Dump them all down right here. We're going to need to get more leaf spots. And I'm just going to keep doing this. Now, unfortunately, what we have to do is bring back one of these sets. So I've put down there, this is our leaf storage, right? And we can't make leaf storage without using the miners in the first place. You need some miners back at home to actually build the leaf storage in the first place, which is mildly annoying, but whatever. More miners, more of them, many, many more. The idea is to go up to like 30 or something like that. I'm just going to mass produce them at the start of the game. I don't really know. I'm just sort of going for it, right? We're just going to pretend I know what I'm talking about. Because this has kicked my ass far too many times for my liking. So, determined to stop that happening now. Now I'm skipping the tooltips because I know what I'm doing. I'm pretending to know what I'm doing. Would be a more accurate description of that. So you see here, we put down these little miner spots, and because they're all joined together, you see these blue ones are all connected, they all join the same pheromone marker group. So this is 13 of them I've put down here, and we've got 7 in here as well that you get by default. You see some of them a little bit sick. How are we doing? 292, absolutely fine. Look at them go, they just climb up. Look at this dude on the left. What an absolute hero. There he goes. I love it, I think it's really cool looking. So, that right there is the main challenge. Collect the most leaves. It's the first to 10,000 wins. My last attempt, I was about 1,000 off. I got to about 9,000 when they hit 10. So, I'm hoping this is going to be the one.
To the north of the nest entrance. However, another adder colony has already laid claim to them. The close proximity of these nests places the two colonies in direct competition with one another. Time will tell which has the potential to grow into a great empire, and which will submit to the unforgiving law of the Undergrowth.
Submit to the unforgiving law of the Undergrowth. I love it. It's so dramatic. It's amazing. Considering it's ants, they really up the drama. Now, we do have to be quite careful around here. You can see these red exclamation marks. That means there's enemies there, basically. And we are not in any position to fight at this point in time. So we're just going to extend very safely, as much as safely as we possibly can, out into the wider environment. Really, I'm just going to keep focusing on ramping up production of our miners right now. Check with control how we're doing. Yep, so we've got plenty of leaves. So they're all heading to this area. There's 40 there, there's 13 there. So you just want to work your way through and clear out the whole map, basically. This is going to be it, folks. I'm going to pull it off this time. I have faith. I've never been ahead. I've had two major attempts on this, and I've never been ahead of the opposition. Because they do get a head start. You saw that already. This is it. This is the time, I'm telling you. This is the one. This is the one. I'm feeling it. I'm feeling good. Because if it doesn't work this time, I like literally officially give up. So we have to make it work this time. So yeah, we're just really ramping up our minor armor. We're up to 24 now. Well, we will be when they all hatch out. I think one thing I've been messing up with as well is not... You kind of want to keep your army up to this. I've been building down here a lot of the time. And the problem is, that's quite far away from the entrance. Your leaf storage and your and this stuff and everything like that. So you want to kind of keep your stuff relatively up at the top. And that should speed up the transport of the leaves and the fungus making and all that stuff. Now you can see here that the big one is unfortunately dead. We're going to move back just a little bit up here where you can see there's quite a few leaves in there as well. We're going to make more of these. Oh, so those are our miners, right? These are good at building, and they're okay at leaf collection. They're not the best, but they're doing a good job. They're giving it a good old go. What we can also get are these. These are media, Atas cephalotes, leafcutter media ant. And these are much better at gathering up leaves. They're very efficient at it. They're very quick at it. So that's what we're going to start focusing on now. We're going to keep increasing these a little bit, because every time we make one of these guys, you can see we get a little minim, and the minims are really useful as well. But we're going to start working on our slightly bigger boys, as they should be called. And keep an eye on over here. Just make sure, again, you can see there's a lack of leaf over here now. So we're going to just move a little bit further to the left. As they all get killed by a spider.
Jumping spider, say Casviri Deeper.
Okay, let's go over here instead. Let's get out of there, shall we?
This expert solo hunter combines extreme agility with incredible forward vision, allowing it to pounce on unsuspecting prey with pinpoint accuracy.
I just killed like 10 of my ants, unfortunately. Now, the thing is, when you put down... I'll show you this. So it costs 20 food to put down a new tile. That's quite a lot. But it only costs 2 to rehatch. So losing a unit isn't that big a deal, in theory.
The forest canopy shrouds all but the slightest glimmer of moonlight. The predators of the night begin to emerge.
The predators of the night begin to emerge. He's so dramatic. He's so ruddy dramatic. I absolutely love it. Okay, our leaf production is looking really good to me. It really is. I'm just going to keep popping out more medias for now. We're going to get up a decent number of those. We will make some mages as well. Those are going to be our fighters, because eventually we'll have to start moving towards the north, where there is, of course, another ant colony. We're not going to worry about that quite yet. We're going to really focus on ramping up our own production before we worry about the enemy. And our production is looking pretty good. I'll say this is going better than last time. Not that that means much, because every other time it's been an absolute goddamn disaster. So there's our medias there. Look, big boys. He's going up. He's going up. Let's watch him. Let's watch him at work. I love it. I think it looks great. How cool is that? This is the kind of game that just doesn't exist these days in a lot of ways, you know? It's the kind of game people don't make anymore, and it's sad. We used to get loads of animal games on the Wii, but the Switch just hasn't gone in that direction yet. It's a big shame for me. I love this kind of game. I really do. We're going to up our waste management a little bit. We can upgrade these tiles, and that's what we'll end up doing. We're looking pretty good. Probably need a bit more leaf storage as well. Again, it's all about cramming it together without crossing over. So you can see all my little minims dragging the fungus over here, the rotting fungus. And that fades over time. You see the minus one, that means that's dropping down. But we're also making more of it every time we make a new ant, so. How are we doing? Keep an eye on this on the left. So we're about 430-ish behind at the moment. How are we doing over here? Is there enough food? Yeah, there's plenty over here right now. There's some fairly spooky looking creatures out there in the middle of the night as well, which we kind of have to keep an eye on, but we're okay for now. I've had them, as you can see, I've turned off combat, so they shouldn't defend themselves, they shouldn't fight, they should just run away, basically. The little dudes are not fighters. See already, this area's getting a little bit tapped out. We're going to move a little bit further to the right. I think there's a way to group these together, but I don't know how you do it. It's okay, we're going alright so far. I'm a little bit nervous about this red, but we are just going to cut through this wall a little bit more. Buy ourselves some more space for our medias. go. And we'll probably go back down here and start making some more miners as well. Now, you can upgrade your ants. I'm not sure how viable it is an approach with the leaf cutters. I suspect with the leaf cutters that just maxing out your numbers is the best way to do it. Now, the theory is if you upgrade your ants instead of maxing out your numbers, then when it comes to replenishing, you're paying the same price for much better ants. But I think the idea is more just don't get them killed in the first place. How are we doing over here? Right, this area is kind of getting a little bit thin on the ground for my liking. So, yeah, we've got a little bit here, but we're going to have to move. I think probably up here is a good shout. Let's start moving up here to the north. And we're going to make some more miners. Miner? I hardly know her. LOL. Right, so you can see we've got kind of a problem here with our refuse. It's fallen prey to a wandering harvest. I think it's stacking up a little bit, so we're going to upgrade those. Vulnerable body elevated high above the leaf litter. Get out of here, son.
It can release strong-smelling odors to deter other predators. A stern response will be needed to drive this striding nuisance away.
Get him! Get him! Get him! Yes! Nom 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 nom. He's got a stun attack. He's got an AoE stun attack, but he will not stand against the might of my little army. There we go. Right back to work.
By the defensive leafcutter forces, the harvestman decides to make a swift exit.
Do a little celebratory dance. You got to really keep an eye out. There's stuff everywhere. Absolutely everywhere. Ants. Dangerous everywhere. The night is dark and full of terrors, ladies and gentlemen. To say the least, the night is dark and full of terrors. Okay, we're still about... We're actually just under 400 behind. I will say, things will get tougher because we'll kind of run out of resources in the area, and that's when we start clashing with the ants in the north, and that's when things get a little bit more difficult. But for now, this is going better than usual. I'll say that much. I think having the leaf collection right here at the entrance is really good. Really, really helpful for speeding up the whole process. It feels like a... Oh, God, look at this. Look at my fungus, though. It's insane. So what we do is we spend a bit of food and we just upgrade these fungus tiles. We don't need to dig out anymore or anything. We can just upgrade them. And that's going to let us get hold a lot more rotting fungus. These are our refuse tiles. You can see the number going up there. Up to 460 now. It's going to go quite a lot higher. Whew, okay.
The ants must defend themselves.
Pish posh. What's going on? Ah, it's just a harvestman. Okay, the harvestmen aren't that big a deal. There's scarier things out there, to say the least. Much scarier things. How are we doing? This area is still... I wouldn't say it's tapped out at all. It's got quite a bit of leaf left. I'll stay here for now. Bum, 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 bum. How are we doing? 300 behind! Come on! Come on! My production is just insane right now. It really is. I really want to start knocking out these walls a little bit, but I am a little bit apprehensive. What we might do... I have no room. This is my problem. I'm going to knock out this wall here and hope for the best. Are we okay? Okay, we're okay. What we're going to do is we're just going to make a couple of mages. These are our big fighting ants. And what we're going to do is hopefully use these to knock out this bit of wall down here on the right. It's only one enemy in there. It shouldn't take that much effort. And we need a couple of mages anyway. They'll defend our ants a little bit better. They'll fight at level 3. They'll have a taunt. They're going to do work. Right, you see here, this is the problem. Our ants aren't doing anything because there's no food in the area. So we need to go... We need to find an alternate spot. That's okay for now. Let's go over here. Moving over to the west. Ants, Alonzi. Look at them all go. A little squad. Makes me happy.
The leafcutters have raised their first major ant. Its swollen head is filled with muscle to power its crushing jaws.
Been there, my friend.
You stand against it in combat and escape unscathed. This champion warrior will make a fine addition to the colony.
Now, we will take those outside. What I just want to do is knock out this wall, hopefully, safely. And I might make one more. I'm so sorry if you can hear that noise. Somebody's ringing the buzzer. And I can't do anything about it. We have to roll with it. I'm just waiting until I hit 150 food. I'm going to make one more major, and then we're going to knock out this wall. There we go. And we need to do something about our refuse again. It's kind of kicking off. It's...
Whew. Daybreak has arrived. and the creatures of the night scurry back to the dark crevices of the undergrowth.
There's some food here, there's not loads. However,
the objectives of the day remain unchanged. Locate vegetation, defend supply lines, and process leaves. There is no time for rest.
So we've got three mages. Once this, you can see them hatching there. There's our next major. So we're going to knock out this wall. And then our mages are going to go and fight. Kill him. No, don't. No, not my little dudes. Get my big dudes in. There we go. Easy peasy.
These rove beetle larvae are distant relatives of the European devil's coach horse. Despite a few million years of separation, they share the same carnivorous appetite, razor-sharp pincers, and most importantly, a fearsome final form.
This is a little spooky sounding. There we go. Let's up our miners completely, like so. Not that one. I don't even know how to undo it, if I'm honest. Oh, right, yeah. There we go. Okay. I think we want about 60 miners based on the video I saw. We need to go back to more medias as well. We actually have loads of food right now. We're going to knock out this wall a little bit more. Again, just trying to do it safely. I'm a little nervous about that one there. We're going to go for it. We're going to go for it. We all over here? We should be all... I'm going to go for this kind of bit over here, right? We're on the way. The Great Ant Army. How are we doing? Only a tiny bit behind. A teeny tiny bit behind. I've never been doing this well before. I only got this far by copying someone else, but that's not the point. It will get harder, like I'm aware of that, but this is going really well. I've actually taken first place for the first time ever.
One of the ants has fallen prey to a young leaf mimic praying mantis.
Whatever. Who cares?
Once in range, its long razor-clad forelegs can ensnare and impale victims with lightning speed.
We're gonna need to up our. Oh no 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 no! We can't go that far though. Oh, that's making me nervous. Let's go over here instead. I think. Let's not do this bit at all. Now this is making my ants sick, unfortunately. But once we've got in there and we've upgraded them. Hopefully we won't have to come down here again, basically, is the idea. I'm sorry, little guys. I really am. And yeah, I'm trying to keep this wall up because it's kind of the boundary between this and this, and we don't want our ants to get sick, if at all possible. I think if I just fill this with our refuse, it should be enough for the rest of the game. Hopefully. There we go. Okay. Looking good. Looking good. Am I still in the head? No, no, I've fallen behind. That's okay, that's okay. How are we doing over here? That's the problem, we've kind of stopped producing, that's why. Let's go down here. You really gotta keep on... You're kind of like trying to juggle two worlds here. The undergrowth and the overgrowth. And if you don't keep an eye on it, you'll just... Like you saw there, our production entirely stopped because I just forgot. All mounts were up here and there's really very little up here at all. There's a little bit over there. So we want to send them down here, hopefully harvest this whole area out, and then we're going to have to go probably up here. This is looking like a really promising area as well. Get those upgrades on there. That should really help. Oh, it's still... Oh, this is a lot quicker than I usually play, so... But we're doing okay, we're doing okay. I might actually be able to upload this video for once. That'd be amazing. What I think we need to do temporarily is bring our big guys back down here and just clear out. We need a bit more room here for our medias, right? There's just no room for them here. So we're going to bring our larger ants back down here. Our mages, hopefully. If they ever make it through. And what we should also do is maybe upgrade our leaf tiles a bit. There we go. Mages, are you going to come join me, or what are you doing over here? Right, okay, let's go up to the north. Because there is nothing here. We've just wiped the area out once again. Where are my mages? There they are, right. There's one of them anyway, there's two of them. Okay, I think we can go for this. It feels risky, I'm not going to lie.
The ants must fight.
Yeah, it's fine. What is it? Actually, I've got so many medium-sized units that I think we're okay. Right, let's slowly work our way through this wall. A little bit apprehensive about what's in here. I don't think I've ever opened this wall before. But if we clear this area, we can knock out this entire bit. It's going to be really good for our sizing. Okay, we should be fine.
There are intruders in the nest.
I know, buddy. I know. Absolutely annihilated them. Nice. There we go. Okay, so what we can do now is knock out all this relatively safely. Buy ourselves a ton of space, which is really cool. Bum, 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 ba-dum, 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 bum, 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 ba-dum. Oh boy. It's going okay. It's so tight though, just look at the difference. It's really, really close. Are we going okay? Are we actually harvesting? Let's just make sure we are harvesting continuously, please. Yeah, this is a really good spot. I want to really focus on up here. There are some spiders, which is a shame. But my mages should be pretty good at taking these down. There we go. Hey, look at that. Annihilated.
Whilst the two Atta colonies joust for territory, Odontomachus Bowery trap jaws roam the clearing. They can be found hunting alone or in small packs for vulnerable invertebrates to take back to their nest. They use snapping jaws to bludgeon their targets, exerting 300 times their body weight in a single blow.
There we go. Okay, okay. Yeah, production is insane. I don't really know what else to say. I'm gonna keep upgrading these as well. Like, my leaf storage isn't that high, but it just doesn't feel like we need it because... Like, the leaves are getting... We've got so many little minions. Look at them go. My little tiny army that we can't control. They do their own thing. And they're just flying through it. They really are. Everyone's at work. Everyone's busy. That's what you want to see. That's all we need to see. Everyone climbing up and chomping down. And we've taken the lead by 200. Phew! Feel good. Feel good. We probably want a few more mages now. I think we want to go up to maybe 6, 7, 8, 9, something like that. Just so there's something large in the army that can kind of take away the brunt of the damage that the opposition are going to try to do. Because you can see we've cleared out basically this whole south region of the map. We're going to start going over here, which is where the opposition is going to go as well. So, we need to be ready for war. That's what it is, folks. Ants, the life of an ant is war. Look at them go! Sorry, I'm very excited about my ant's army. And because I've spent so long today trying to do this, and yesterday, and the day before. And it's funny, because the Leafcutters do require just a different playstyle. I had no problem with the first four levels. I actually did pretty well. I was kind of proud of myself, because I've struggled with this game in the past. But I kind of, like, it just clicked for me, you know? I kind of got the hang of it. And then the Leafcutters came around and just kicked my ass all over again. Which is cool, that you can have such different mechanics when all you're doing is controlling ants. But it does require a little bit of getting used to say the least. Okay, right. I said I was going to save up some mages, so we'll do that next. How are we doing over here? There's a little bit left. I think it's time to start moving up here, though. So let's start that. Oh, just little insects and little random things popping around, jumping spiders and, you know, all these billions of things that are going to try to eat my face, basically. Now, you can see they're coming down here as well.
Yes, must fight.
It's the same area, because this area is kind of dead. This whole sort of... I mean, we could probably send some over here, right? That looks... Yeah, that was... You want to stick your ants together. You know, you want to be protecting your little babbies, so... I've soared into the lead here. Just mass production. Just mass... If you have been playing this and you've been struggling because you're not used to the playstyle because it is different, I would suggest with other ants that the regular ants that... I can't remember what they're called, Formicafusca, stuff like that, that the upgrades are quite important. With these guys, just mass produce. Just... churn out as many spots as you can, basically. Seems to be the winning strategy, anyway. I keep saying I'm going to buy some mages, and then I keep just making more medias. I love my medias. Look at them. Amazing. Crazy how nature do that, eh? Crazy. You guys, get out! This is my town, you hear me? My town. You're not allowed here. Go away.
These leaves are contested.
No, they're not.
Leafcutters will generally not attack unless provoked. But today, there's too much at stake. Only a strong show of force will deter the opposing colony.
No contest here, son. It's just a slaughter, you hear me? Just a goddamn slaughter. Get out! They're gonna keep sending some units down, but they'll give up eventually, basically. What you can do is just break their supply lines entirely.
night falls, and under the cloak of darkness, velvet worms, bush crickets, and harvestmen emerge from their hiding places. Any ant straying from the relative safety of the trail likely meet with an unfortunate end.
I will say, I've never seen a velvet worm. Unless this is a velvet worm, which I don't think it is. I've never seen a velvet worm. It's very pretty, though. Anyways, what's it going to do? Oh, it's going to make big boys. There we go. Three more big boys.
The
How are we doing?
Leafcutters have retreated from one of their harvesting sites. They may have been easily startled this time, but they'll soon be back.
Saying that, this site is near enough dead already. There's really not much here, unfortunately. I mean, we go over here. There's a bit over here. Little things are trying to pop in every now and again, but when you've got so many of these medias, you kind of just beat them off, basically. Beat them off. Is that what I want to have said? I don't know. This is my only problem right now is like a lack of space. Although I suspect, to be honest, I could live with the army I've got now and we'd probably make it to the end. If we can find some resources, because that is the site. There's a whole bunch over there, but it's very far away. What's going on here? Who is you? You cheeky little blighter. Go do one. Look at that. Look at that leaf production. Amazing. What's this? This is Harvestman. Oh, you're spooky. Maybe you are a velvet worm. Don't look like it, though. No, you're not. What am I about? These are the Devil Court Coach Horse relatives, right? Wow. There's a little bit of food up here. This isn't as bad as I thought. This whole area over here. But once that's clear, we'll move over to the left a little bit. But we're going to need somewhere else. We can maybe go back over here. We're 1,300 ahead. I can't believe I'm actually going to win. I'm actually blown away. Genuinely. Leaf stores are full. Oh, yikes. Right, okay, let's do that. Let's upgrade our leaf storage a little bit. Like so. And we can actually upgrade the blocks as well. How upgrades work is basically if a block is surrounded by more blocks, you can upgrade up. And you need to keep upgrading those blocks to upgrade further, basically. I don't know. Oh, God. Oh, that's a hell of an army. Right, I think we should get out of here. Or should we just fight? I can't decide. I feel like I'm getting annihilated. Yeah, they've got a huge force. Let's just get out of here. Stop killing my ants! It's rude. See them all sweeping over to the left instead. There's some food over here. It's not much, though. It's really not. We'll have to come up with an alternative. There's a lack of food in this area now.
A Paracanthus varius bush cricket has spotted the ants. Its thorax and appendages are adorned with sharp protruding spikes, offering 360 degrees of protection and turning its substantial forelegs into a pair of deadly flails.
Deadly
this
flails.
This devil will not easily be deterred.
Get my mages on him, not a problem. Beat him up. Come on, lads. Go on. Gangbang him.
The hillside at a colony is falling behind. With their demise at hand, they have no choice but to strike back at their opponent.
Oh, that sounds spooky. Don't strike back at your opponent. I'm your opponent! Okay, again we have this issue where there's nothing here. There's no resources for frickin' miles. I don't really know where to go. We can go over there, I guess. It's not great, though. I honestly feel like we might have to head into... I mean, this area's okay. And they're there, but we can fight. That's fine. Okay, since we have so many points, what we're going to do first is just upgrade our mages a little bit. There we go. Got to spend some food on something. I don't really have room for expansion anymore, right? So we're just going
to
upgrade at this point.
To the northwest.
How are we doing? Are we doing okay? Oh my god. Oh, this is a hell of a clash. I'll give it that
predators
much.
Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be
protected. Wait, what? Not anymore, it's not. Look how many ants. The game is struggling a little bit. The FPS is dropping. There's so many minims. Every single one of these spots is giving me a minim, so the minim production rate is insane. How are we doing? Are we holding our own up here? I think so. Five hundred to go. Oh, we've got this. We've absolutely got this in the bag. I'm just going to keep upgrading where I can. I'm not sure about the... I don't know if the upgrades upgrade the ants that are already alive. Never actually thought about that before. That'd be interesting to know. But, yeah, there we go. We absolutely took it from them. Okay, so
we'd the colony has retreated from one of its sites to the northwest.
There's no food.
Unguarded foliage, ripe for the picking.
You say that, but there's not. It's all bloody gone already. We were so close. I just need to grab anything I can find. We're getting a little bit here. Little bit, really not much. Oh, let's go over that. That's an 800. That should be enough, actually. That might take us over the top. I don't think it means it's worth 800. It might mean it's worth 800 leaves, because look at the size of it. It's an absolute unit. I mean, it's probably like this big. You can't see what I'm doing, but I'm holding up a finger. Do I have long fingers? I may have quite short fingers. Interesting. I have big hands, but short fingers. My palm is huge. I've never noticed that before. Anyway, it's moving on. How are we doing on our... Yeah. Just going to keep upgrading. The minims, just hordes of them. The queen has been pumping ants out like it's nobody's business. And it's not, you know, if she wants to pump out ants, who are you to judge her? Leave her alone. I will say as well, we've done this in 36 minutes.
Has begun.
You know, we're going to pull this off in about 36 minutes. Last time, oh, look at that. That's a sight for sore eyes. That is beautiful. The green train, choo choo. It's absolute huge line of leaves getting carted back home. I'm just gonna watch. Look at that, it's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. Just gonna watch them bring home the victory. We go back into here, you should start to see them pop up and drop the leaves down. Any second now. Any second now. There we go. Dropping off their hoard.
A fight has broken out over the harvesting rights to a sapling.
Nice! Okay, maybe I've got this down.
Subdued their rivals and achieved dominion over the clearing. As the competition withers, they will extend their territory in all directions, firmly establishing their agricultural empire. One day, this colony will number in the millions.
Good job, lads. Good job. Victory for Atacephalotes. I'm going to get some... I actually don't think I need the royal jelly that badly. We're going to get territory. So, we just got three resources. Royal jelly, territory, and food. We take those back to the former Carrium. Territory lets us expand the base. Food kind of gets plopped down on the surface and we can go collect it, as you can see.
Come on now, my little ants. You need space to grow. Dig, dig.
I'm sorry, what was that?
I wasn't talking to you.
Okay, so they've jumped loads of these down on the surface, and now we can go and we can extend our former Kerim. We can use the gel, the royal jelly we just got, to buy upgrades and stuff like that. So you can see, I've actually already unlocked the Leafcutter mages. I got the stun ones rather than torn, which I might regret. And you can get like little upgrades and stuff like that, so cannot take more than 20 damage in a single attack, or all incoming damage reduced by 3. So you can kind of pick like which upgrades you want. Or this and nearby creatures take 30% less damage, which sounds really good. Or this and nearby creatures reflect 30% damage back to the damaging... How is sharp not better than resilient? Does reflect not imply that you also take 30% less? It does to me. Interesting. Okay, we'll grab that. That's quite a lot. Do I want to get the upgrade first? No, let's grab that. Boop. And we've got 116 jelly left. We can get an upgrade for our wood ant mortars. Let's increase their... Yeah, let's grab that. Okay, so we can then upgrade this whole Formicarium bit and go and tackle the next level, which is 3.2, the front line. But yeah, I'm really happy about that. So I think the tactic with the leaf cutters when doing their levels is just mass numbers. First, just make tons of miners, tons and tons and tons of miners, and then go from there and just scale up your production really early on. Because we struggled to get ahead for a while, but then it was just bam. We clearly had a much better baseline than they did by the end of the game. And if you make loads of medias, they're not fighters necessarily, but they can fight if absolutely need be. And if you've got 60 of them out there, then they're going to be able to fight and win no matter what, so... Okay, anyways, that is the Leafcutter update for Empires of the Undergrowth. I really recommend you check out this game if you're into animal games, if you played Simant when you were younger. I don't know if that's a reference that's a little bit too old now for some of you guys at home, but Simant was a brilliant game. And the devs are really great people, and the game itself is pretty awesome. Go check it out. It's on Steam. I'll see you lovely folks next time. If you enjoyed the video, chuck me a like. Cheers from myself as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.